Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Today we are going to present about an analysis of code mixing in Didi Corbusier video YouTube. Okay, next. The first is study significance. The aim of this research are about first to find out the types of code mixing used in YouTube video by Didi Corbusier, and then second to describe Didi Corbusier factor for using mixing code in this YouTube video. Nowadays, the use of social media is familiar in our generation, and the most popular social media is YouTube. In this research, motivational content creator, namely Didi Corbusier, has a lot of critical thinking, and he used language variation like code mixing to deliver his opinion. And in Indonesia itself, using code mixing during communication is a normal thing that becomes style of speaking. Like Didi Corbusier, he often used code mixing in daily communication. So that from this research, the researcher wants to analyzing the use of code mixing by Didi Corbusier in his YouTube video. Next.
Okay, this is for the grounded theory of the research. The sociolinguistic about the code mixing based on Hoffman's theory that describes about the types of code mixing. Okay, there are three types here. First, intrasensorial mixing, which contains word, phrase, and clauses. This type of switching, speakers switch from one language to another in the same sentence. So the sentence will be made up of two or more language. And then second one is intra-lexical code mixing, which contains prefix and suffix. This kind of code mixing occurs in a word boundary. And the last one, involving a change of pronunciation. This kind of mixing happens on phonological level. It is like when Indonesian says an English word and modified into Indonesian phonological structure. And then for Holmes theory, okay, Holmes theory, it talks about the factors of the reason people choose the code before they were speaking. First, bilingualism and multilingualism. Okay, this phenomenon of using two language or more by speakers in interaction is called bilingualism and multilingualism. And the second one is discuss a particular topic. People select the code while interact and discuss about some topic because it's easier for them while speaking. And the third, social distance dimension. A person could speak in different code depending on with whom they interact with. And the relationship of the status for some people can be intended as a way while selecting appropriate code. And the fourth, formality dimension. Speakers will change the code based on the situation where the speakers take the conversation. So the features of the setting and the dimension of formality is important in selecting appropriate code. And the five, goal of interaction. Its speakers must have goal to get when interacting. For example, the speakers use the code mixing and the conversation will be interesting or raise prestige. That's all for the grounded theory of this research.
Okay, thank you. And the next is about the research methodology. So I already highlight two points here. The first is about this paper utilized descriptive qualitative research. So descriptive qualitative research was used to reveal social phenomenon in relation to code mixing issues exist in Didi Corbusier's YouTube videos. And the second point is about the techniques which used by the researcher. There are two techniques here. The first one is observation. The researcher utilized observation technique to observe the YouTube channel and Didi Corbusier in Didi Corbusier and find out the video with the category of motivation which contains code mixing, specifically with the researcher chose four videos. And for the documentation technique referred to the data obtained from Didi Corbusier's YouTube videos. Next, about the result. Is me.
For the result, I will explain about the result. The result showed that the researcher found Indonesian English code mixing from the four videos are 115 data. As explained before, there are three types of code mixing, including intrasentential, word, phrase, and clause, intralexical, prefix, suffix, and the last is involving a change of pronunciation. Moreover, the number of data from the whole code mixing videos are divided into several percentage in diagram of code mixing. And the highest percentage of this code mixing found in Deddy Corbuzier's video is intrasentential mixing in the form of words, which reached 39%, and the lowest is 2% intralexical or prefix. Next. The example of code mixing found in Deddy Corbuzier's video, data 091, yang punya sertifikat sebagai master di Winchun. This data belongs to the types of intrasentential mixing because Deddy insert the words from a foreign language master in his native utterance. Second, data 41, menurut gua gak diajarin tuh gimana cara bermain memaintain Instagram. This data belongs to code mixing because Deddy combines the English words maintain with an Indonesian prefix me, which has meaning to. And the third is data 093, tapi buat mereka yang gak tahu, they destroy their life just by social media. And the last is data 019, ya gua gak tahu ntar lu ngatain gua bahwa gua unsocial. Okay, next.
Okay, next. Actually, the researcher doesn't obviously state or mention about the implication of the knowledge in this paper. However, we have summarized and conclude some points. The implication of the study to our knowledge is to enrich the knowledge about code mixing phenomenon, which is part of linguistic field, especially social linguistics. As we know, the focus of this study is to find out the types of code mixing used by Deddy Corbuzier and to describe the factor behind it. For further studies, this result can be used to motivate other researchers to conduct similar study, especially study about code mixing phenomena with different objects and problems. That's all from our group. Thank you.